says down here, skill opens up 40% chance when fear or true fear is placed. So we got that. And I think I can go ahead and one-shot them right now. What are you talking about? What the f- my god. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Grimnum here, back again with another Raid Shadow Legends video. And no, you did not see that incorrectly. That was a Fortis damage test a week ago on Arena. And yes, I was pissed off. If you watched my Fortis damage pre-buff video, then you'll notice that I was giving him a whole lot of leeway here. I was saying, you know, he hits pretty hard. You know, he might be able to nuke this champion and all that. But if you just saw that clip and you saw how pissed off I was, yeah, that was just fucking pitiful. That Fortis' secret skill, which is supposed to be hitting, you know, pretty hard, is not even able to one-shot or clear Siphi or Arbiter right there in that moment, right? How upsetting. So in today's video, we got the new Fortis buff in the game now with the latest patch, 8.20.0. Before I show you that, I'm going to show you a couple other clips from this video, if you didn't see, that we can take a look at the previous damage, and then I'm going to, of course, toss them back into some of the same teams here and see what I can do with a buffed Astral Terror's Fortis. I'm so excited. So that was, let me rewind this just a little bit. This is at 105.40. So I was pretty confident here that Fortis was going to be able to finish off Siphi and Arbiter. Now he gets the Arbiter, I think, but not being able to kill the Siphi here is just so embarrassing for a Void Legendary champion with the secret skill, right? All right, here it is again. 22,000 damage. About 40,000 damage on Arbiter there. Of course, Siphi probably has more HP. She's got more defense. But this number, regardless, is just dog shit. Yeah. Now, I'm going to show you another clip here. Time-stamped at about 49 minutes and like 40 seconds. Take a look here. So, I have it set up where Fortis is about to do Astral Terrors. Let's take a look here. I'm going to try to slow it down as well once we get to the part. All right, here it is. So Astral Terrors going out on the field. This was pre-patch Fortis, before the buff, okay? Keep that in mind. Here it is. 29,000 on Wukong, 16,000 on, you know, 16,000, 32,000. Yeah, not a whole lot of damage there. I mean, you really would think that Mithrala would be dead. Of course, Wukong would be dead, but not even being able to kill the Cardiel here. Now, Cardiel is a strong champion, but not being able to kill anyone else here that's a low HP, yeah, very shitty, very pitiful. As you can tell, these numbers, damage numbers, nothing has exceeded 40,000 yet. Nothing over 40,000. So let's go to 57 minutes in. 57 minutes. Yeah, this is a long video. 57:20. If you want to see the build and all that stuff, check out that video. But I'm also going to go over a lot of it in this video too. So 57:20. Here is another instance of Astral Terrors. All right, so we have Vogoth, Harima, and Ultimate Death Knight. A very tanky trio right there. 24,000, 24,000 again on Harima, and then it looks like 51,000 on Vogoth. Vogoth might just be a bit of a sponge tank going on. Understandable that with Harima on the team, I'm hitting a lot weaker, but it's crazy that these numbers are still in the same realm as other teams that we just saw. 24,000 on Ultimate Death Knight, 24,000 on Harima. Let me see that one more time. More time here. Bam. All right. Nothing to be happy about there on that. Now, last clip on this will be at 1 minute. Sorry, 1 hour and 10 minutes. Right about here. Right. So if I'm looking at this right here, I'm expecting that, you know, first of all, I'm expecting Astro Terrorist to clear the whole team, kill everybody. Now, what I should expect based on what I know Astro Terrorist can do is that I could kill Skullcrown. I can kill Mashaled, you know, maybe Necrit. I don't know, but we're going to find out what kind of damage should I do in this clip here. Okay, 61,000 to a Skullcrown, 33,000 to Necrit, 50,000 to Arbiter, 66,000 to Mashaled. Now, this team, probably not the tankiest, definitely not the tankiest, and I think this player wasn't a very endgame player. I mean, he had some good champions here, but endgame, I would say no. All right, so here we are, guys. On the game in 8.20.0 with Fortis after his damage buff. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and test that out today. All right, so today I'm gonna be showing off Timmit in arena and maybe do some dungeon stuff. But here's what I got him in. This is the same build I had him in last week. Maybe a little more defense. I don't remember exactly, but I didn't really change anything on him. He doesn't even have a blessing, so can't even get any bonuses from stats, right? So no bonuses here. Maybe a little bit of change to some of his defense if I had to guess correctly. And he's almost at 6,000 defense, which is great. Could use a boost in HP for sure. I could probably even throw in some ascensions here on him, to be honest. But we're told that there has been a buff to his Astral Terror's secret skill, his like A3 basically. Attacks all enemies, will ignore 30% of each target's defense against targets under True Fear and Fear debuffs. I wish they would take that out of the game. Don't make it so they have to have True Fear or Fear, whatever. This attack is always critical against those under those debuffs. The damage of the skill increases by 10% every time a True Fear or Fear debuff is placed on an enemy. I don't know if that's like a thing that passively stacks, even if there's no fears on them when he hits them. I don't know if it's like if 7 fears have been placed through the total of the battle, is that like 70% more damage when he hits? I don't know. And frankly, it's kind of hard to test all that stuff. But the team here we're going to be doing and using today will be, let's go ahead and try this team here. Will of course be with my boy, my guy. I think there was Timmit on the team. Let's go ahead and get Fortis here. It was Timmit, Fortis, and I think the fourth spot was a rotation between Mithrala for the increased defense buff, Ultimate Death Knight for his A2 that also places a fear debuff on everybody if he lands, and there was also Emek to help keep me alive. Also with Emek on the team, when Fortis goes down to like 1 HP, he also gets a lot stronger too. So for the most part, I'm just going to use Timmit here to strip the debuffs and also place fears, and then Fortis will come in, and I should just start off with Ultimate Death Knight on the team here. So we're going to manual this. All right, I'm so excited to finally test this new Fortis damage. I almost keep saying Timmit. But let me ask you guys, what do you think is going to be the damage outcome here? I'm expecting like 80,000, 70,000 minimum, 80,000 minimum. If we break over 100,000 damage, I know that doesn't sound like a lot, but for this champion Fortis to hit for 100,000 damage on an enemy with his secret skill is a huge milestone. Okay, that doesn't put him in any platinum and any meta stuff. I mean, if he's hitting 200,000, right? Because we didn't even see the change that they did. I don't know if Hell Hades website has the multipliers. I'll look up the website after this. But let's go ahead and try this, all right? Because before we were hitting about 40,000 damage, between 20 to 50,000. Let's just say between 20 and 50,000 damage was the pre-patch damage test, okay? There we go. We got some fears out there on the field. Here goes the first ever Fortis Astro Terror's damage test. 60,000... 40,000. I don't know. I'll try this again. That wasn't that much. That wasn't that much. I'm gonna test this again. I'm gonna put Mithrala on the team. No buff to that A2 damage. Man, what a kind of a weak hit there still. He didn't kill anybody that wasn't already dead. I don't think. Maybe he'll have it again. Let's see, because there's a fear out there. Yep, so there's another fear out there, so let's try this one more time. Well, at least he gets it back pretty quickly. 23, 14. What are these numbers? He's not even hit. I didn't see the damage to Trunda there. I missed it, but let's see if we can get this one more time. So what I'm saying, guys, if he could break over 100,000 damage, it would make him insane. We get it? We got it one more time. All right, let's pay attention here. One more time on this. Fortis damage test. 102,000 damage. Okay, and that was with the fear on the champion. Okay, that was with a fear on the champion. Okay, a lot of damage. I didn't see the numbers there at the end. We're gonna take a look at that a little more here as we go. But I'm looking for some tanky teams, something like this. And I'm gonna take out Ultimate Death Knight. I'm gonna put Mithrala on the team so we get that increased defense buff as well. Make sure I have stuff on Mithrala here. Okay. All right, let's try this again. That was a little underwhelming. I'm gonna be honest. All right, so pretty chunky health blocks here. Don't expect them to be built super, super tanky, to be honest. But it's how well I do against this Death Knight, this Pythion. That's what really matters to me. Okay. I land it. There's a fear, and here's Astro Terrors. All right. So let's see if I can one-shot Ultimate Death Knight. Now, there's no chance that Fortis last week before the buff could kill Ultimate Death Knight right here, right now. There's no chance he could have done it. So let's go ahead and test this right now after the buff. 103,000, 73,000 to Mithrala there. We didn't even hurt Pythian. I don't remember if he had stone skin on or not. That was some good damage, though, to Ultimate Death Knight. Not gonna lie, pretty good damage on Ultimate Death Knight. Let me slow down Wukong here a little bit if I can. Okay, I'm gonna need a bit of a cleanse. Let's see if I can drop a fear on anybody. Got one fear out there on Wukong. Can't cleanse. All right. Yeah, let me know what you guys think about this. I mean, so far it's not standing out to me as anything special. And then the fact that when I come back around with Fortis and I have Astral Terrors, there's nobody on the enemy team that has a fear debuff right now at all, because it's not protected. It's not like Astral Terrorist places a fear debuff before it attacks, which would be really nice. Yeah, so all these teams that you're going to fight where you're going to place that fear, they're going to have it cleansed by the time you get around to it, which is why you need to bring somebody like Timmit. Because if you don't have a champion who's going to place the fears for Fortis, then you're never going to get to utilize that damage bonus, right? Because they're gone. There's no fears. Let's go ahead and test the damage again here. Bro, what is that? That's nothing. That's nothing. There's no damage there at all. That is so weak. That is so weak. I'm going to hold off on that on the A3. I'm going to wait till Fortis is back up. But yeah, dude, people were given Fatalis a whole bunch of crap, saying he's going to be dead before he gets to kill anybody, before he's not going to do any damage. Man, I think Fortis takes the cake for still like worst legendary void in the game. Fatalis is way better than this. I wasn't that upset about the damage he was doing before, since I knew there was a buff coming, but since the buff is here and this is what we get, brother, no. That is not right. Let's try this one more time. Try this again here. There is a fear on Pythion, man. Please take away, player, and please remove this requirement for the fears on them so that we can ignore the defense. Can I just ignore 30% defense at all times with this skill, please? Can we have protected fears? You know what I mean? Can we have something? Make this guy a master of fear debuffs, right? And now this is on a 3-turn cooldown, so I don't know if this was on a cooldown passive before, but right now it is. I don't know if I, or am I getting mixed up? It's the 15% extra chance that they are going to miss their turn, I thought that would be active all the time, so I don't know. Let's go in with this A3 damage test. Okay, 100 something, 140,000. That was a lot of damage. Okay, that was quite a lot of damage. He still didn't surpass Timmit though. Quite a lot of damage to the champions who actually had a fear on them. Let's get in here with this team here. Very tanky team, very strong. Siffy, Ultimate Death Knight, Harima, Wukong. Trying to come in here with increased defense. Reduced all those. See if I can place. So what's the deal here? Did I not place fear with a 65% chance of proccing on them or what? That doesn't make any sense why they would all get a turn there. What? This is actually really annoying. This is not even champion, not even worth fucking using at this point. Man, I was so excited for Fortis to be finally fucking good. And they're just going. They're just taking their turns. Okay. She didn't take her turn, but she doesn't have a fear on herself anymore. Anyway, let's go ahead with this Astral Terrors and see what we can do. What am I hitting? 27,000. Ah, it's worse than I thought, guys. This is not good at all. I am not happy about this. No, no way at all. Fortis, after the buff, is still fucking terrible. Plarium, what are you doing with this champion? Oh my god. Can I go? No, can't. And they're just gonna have their way here with me. Gonna do whatever they want. Can I place anything? No, they got block block debuffs, right? It would be nice if the fears can't be resisted, you know, can't be blocked, can't be resisted. Would be so nice if that were the case. Give this fucking Void Legendary a fighting chance to do anything. My god. I waited this long for this. At this point, the Angar buff is way better. You know, that's the highlight. The Angar buff, you know, 2-turn provoke with a 3-turn cooldown. That's the same as Nergigante, right? So we're not going to beat that team with this setup here. What a joke. What a joke. Let's try this one. And I'm going to take off Mithrala. She's not that great, if you ask me. Especially for this setup here. I'm going to bring in Ultimate Death Knight. Okay. Can I land any fears? Okay, got 3 fears out on the board. Didn't get the secret skill proc. Can I get him to fear? No. And he's going to go in with the peril if he takes a turn. I don't want that to happen. Where is my secret skill at? Is it 2 turns? It's a 1-turn hit, so whatever. And I think more 2 is going to come in here and kill me anyway. Unless I can get the stun out. Can I get a stun? Oh, okay. That was pretty nice. About the most spectacular thing that Fortis has done this entire video. Here we go again. I might have the secret skill unlocked. Here it is. Secret skill unlocked. I'm going to go ahead and try and kill Pythion. That is the goal here. Can I kill Pythion with the secret skill? 76,000, 20-something thousand on Pythion. There's no, like power creep from this guy at all. If you thought that, if you believed that this buff was going to bring Fortis out of the vault and put him up there on par with some of the other Void Legendaries in this game, you just might want to keep him in the vault, guys. I hate to say it. I really hate to say it since I'm a person who owns this champion. And that's the last thing I want is to be upset about a champion's skills, the multipliers, the damage. That is the last thing I want. I was a huge proponent for Fortis being good. Let's see what we can do here. 60,000, 47,000 on Ultimate Death Knight. I don't get it. Where is the damage? Doing less than 50,000 damage to Ultimate Death Knight is insane, dude. I don't even understand. Alright, let's just finish this fight out. Was I too much of a believer? Were you guys believers as well? If you were a believer from Fortis, coming through for once with his damage, you know, I'm sorry. All right, that this is the reality. But, you know, here we go. Final hit. Oh, no, it doesn't even have it. 15,000 damage. That wasn't the Astral Terrors. That was just the A2, but I'm like, pissed off. I'm fucking pissed off at this. This is the dumbest shit ever. What's with all these same teams? It's Wukong, it's Harima, it's Mortu. Give me someone else, man. Give me someone else. But let's try this. Who can we try here? Get a little more speed and also try to remove those buffs a little better. So I can get the accuracy increase with our bias here. Our bias gets the accuracy increase. So Timmit can still not do what he was gonna do. Okay, wow. But okay, there's one. And we got Astral Terror's proc, but this isn't gonna do anything. This is going to do nothing. This is going to do absolutely nothing to Pythion or anyone else. But here we go. This is what you gave us, Plarium. This is that buff that we've been waiting for over a year now. Fucking ridiculous, man. Is this... It just gets worse and worse every time. Worse and worse. Alright, so we got... We're still in the game. Still in it. I don't think I'm gonna beat this team. With Fortis on the team at all. This is a huge disappointment for me. I'm sorry to say. This is just a very, very disappointing moment to see this champion hit as weak as he was before. Okay, I don't even think I want to take him into a dungeon, but I'll throw him into something. Yeah, that's sad. That is very, very sad. Let's take him into a fight like this where it seems like there's at least a chance for me to one-shot. Let's see how much damage I can do against a weaker style team here. I mean, if I didn't have the setup correct here, let me know. I mean, but the Timmit with the fear setup, you know, very strong for in Fortis's favor. This is not any detriment to Fortis with the setup here, but it's when he comes in and it's his turn to go and he just fucking sucks. I mean, I couldn't even use Astral Terrors there. It might have hit for a billion damage, I don't know, but whatever. That's enough of arena there. Let's jump into at least one dragon dungeon here. What is this? This is going to be on 23 or something. Let's just do 23. All right, so here's what I got going on right now. Hopefully this is a good setup to get some damage. So we're gonna have Aja speed up. Timmit's gonna, you know, place the fears if he can. Mithral is gonna boost the defense, and Lydia will do a defense down and weaken on the enemy, and then Fortis should come in with the Astral Terrors. Okay, hopefully this works out the way I'm thinking. Let's go ahead and run it. This will be the last test I do. Not really happy about it so far. I'm gonna strip this guy of all of his gear and toss him in the fucking vault once this is over. Okay, there's some fears right there. Boom. Defense down and weaken. Alright, so there's nothing that should hold me back from doing like 200,000 damage and clearing this whole wave. Oh my god, there's nothing that should stop Fortis from clearing this whole wave. Except for Plarium themselves. Alright, here we go, guys. Okay, what was that? Like 200 something thousand damage? Okay. So what? A damage increased against wave content? That was some strong looking damage, I'm not gonna lie. Let's see if I can pull off anything else like that without needing all those buffs and debuffs. There it is. We got Astral Terrors again, just procced off of that one fear right there. All right, let's try this again. Here it goes. 70-some thousand, 85,000. Okay. So we're getting some decent damage here on Fortis now when we're not in arena. So what's the deal, player? Is this guy just a PvE champion? But isn't his aura an aura for arena? I can't remember. Let me see what else I can do here. Here we go. Another Astral Terrors. Okay, we're getting it back to back to back. That is awesome. That's the only bonus to this right now, is how many times we're getting this. Here we go. 120,000, 130,000 damage. Okay, so arena is not where you're going to be using this guy at all. You're going to be using Bordas against a PvE wave based content. All right, here we go. I think we're going to have one more proc on it. So I've had it 3 times in a row now. I think this is the 4th. I don't know. This might be the 3rd, actually. But here we go. Final one. 429,000 damage. Wow, that is impressive. I can't land a fear on the boss here. That is a very, very bad, you know, very downside negative thing to Fortis here. You cannot land the fear or true fear on a boss. So he's really just going to be wave content only, as it seems. Wow. That 400, almost 500,000 damage. I mean, let me know if any champion of the game could just do that normally. But that was pretty impressive to me. I don't know if that's going to put him in any of my teams, to be honest. But we'll see. Let me toss him into one Doom Tower stage after this. All right, there you have it, guys. So 2.7 million damage from Fortis. This is not, you know, who you'd want to use to fight the dragon, but clearing those waves, he was pretty strong clearing those waves. That was some seer type damage there, honestly. Now, on Hell Hades website, let's see this. Check this out. So they did not update his Astral Terrorist multiplier. It is still the same as it was, 3.5 for the defense here. And unless they did, Oh, it says ratings are being updated. I don't know what's going on here, but I think this is the same as it was from before. Right now, they haven't changed it, is all I'm saying. But I'm going to jump in on a Doom Tower stage and just see what he can do to, let's say, help you clear a very tough wave. Which one was it? One of these waves here where you have to fight like Rhodos, I think, and Mortu, and all these champions that are really tough to face. Is it 111? Where was one? All right, so this is going to be stage 115 Doom Tower hard. I don't know if this one was that hard. I don't know what one is, the very, very tough stage. But let's go ahead and try Fortis here and see what he does. Because if it's just wave-based PvE content, then I guess he's been buffed. But I would not still use this guy in Arena or have any high hopes for this champion in Arena. Here we go. Can we get... Oh, it didn't proc. Let me try that again. Replay. Okay. Now, I did just see that Saf posted a video saying Fortis is fixed, working as intended. I disagree. He's not. He still isn't in my book. This is not what a lot of players are going to be happy about. Anyway, let's go ahead and see if he can one-shot this wave. And one. He did a lot of damage, but not a one-shot, right? Now let me end this fight and see if this is who I had before. Okay, let's see how long it takes them to get through that wave that was just there. It's not. I'm not saying this will be quicker. I'm just saying I think the damage that Fortis did was really good in comparison. Okay, so they're getting through this wave, but that single hit from Fortis on the whole wave was really strong. Fatalis is awesome. I love his animations coming in there. But, okay, so it's taken him a little bit longer to clear this wave. Whereas, let's say I have to set it up. All right, here we go. I got a team set up here. they should auto and do everything correctly. Let's see how long I can it takes me to get through that wave on auto. Okay. Per meter, increase damage. Fears out there. Drop defense weakened. Astral Terrors. Sick. Okay, so they're almost all dead. But with a team like this, it is only Timmit and Fortis right now. But I think I would remove like Mithrala from the team at least, and put maybe another damage dealer. So that was pretty quick. That was a good, nice speed to clear all that. Let's see if they can do it again. Oh, and I'm sorry, slowing it down a little bit. Fortis coming in with a huge, massive hit on the wave. That's so nice. That was a nice, clean hit. So, yeah, I mean, if you want to use this guy against waves in Doom Tower, it looks like he can really pull it off. There is an A2 smack. A2 still hits terrible. Let's see what happens. Boom, 161,000. Definitely making this a faster run altogether. I may actually put Fortis. There it is. Boom. That was huge. So this was originally an 81 turn fight. Now changed to about a 55 turn fight. Yeah. Wow. So definitely improved my time in this. Here, let me show you. In this run with Fortis. So I do like his damage against wave-based content. As long as you have the right setup here. Now again, you don't need Mithrala. I think Lydia is still great to have. You could ultimately take out both Lydia and Mithrala and just put two more damage dealers there. For instance, let's say I did remove them and put, just for the fun of it, just put like Razzlevarg and Fatalis there, you know, just to get some more damage. Let's see how fast this goes and clears. That was like a minute 24, and it was 55 turns, but it says 48. I don't know why. Let's run this again. See what it does. So, I mean, is it right to say that, you know, hey, I'm happy that Fortis is doing more damage in PvE content? And to just completely overlook the fact that he still sucks in PvP? I don't know. All right, so this is actually not better. Didn't actually do much better for us here. I'm over half the turn count in the first wave. Yeah. But yeah, that's it, guys. I mean, for the most part, it looks like Fortis did get that damage buff to his, you know, his A3. Let me try Lydia here. Let's just run it one more time. This will be it. Okay. Secret skill unlocked. All right. So without the increased defense, we still hit quite a bit less. All right. I'm sure I would have been able to clean these guys through if we didn't have that. One more. All right. I'm sorry. One more. Here's what I'm gonna do, because there's no buffs on these guys to begin with, which means that I can get Kaja off the team, right? And I can still do the double A2, A3 with Timmit. There it is. I don't know if we unlock the hidden skill. Boom, okay. Was that 700,000 damage? Let me see that one more time. Was that 700,000 damage? Hidden skill unlocked, okay. All right, so decrease the defense with his ability. So there's even more decreased defense out there. All right, they're actually coming at us with some of their abilities here. Oh, and I can get the cleanse. Come on, Fortis. Here it is. How much damage can I do? Final hit. No, that wasn't 700,000. It might have been. I mean, I don't see any fears. They I think some of them took their turn, but man. Anyway, if you're excited about this buff to Fortis, let me know. I'm still like 50-50. He hits hard in PvE, but PvP really needs some work, guys. And one more time, showing you that Fortis build. Savage with some perception. I should just take him out of the perception. I wasn't using it at all. Here is the masteries on him. You know, it's whatever. But yeah. Anyway, if you like this video, please leave a like, and I will see you guys again next time. Thanks.